Sir, does this look like a real solid object to you? It's not an illusion, is it?
Can I open it?
Yeah, if you want. To be careful, I'm not insured.
Yeah, that's pretty solid.
It's a little pocket knife, am I right?
Yep.
A little pen knife.
Yep.
Do you know why it's called a pen knife?
I do not know.
Hardly anybody does. In the old days, they used to make pens out of feathers. So they have a little knife like this to carve the feather into a quill pen. They call those pen knives. Thomas Jefferson, our president, invented the first folding pen knife just such as this one. So you see, the act is educational as well as entertaining. Now, when that knife reappears back over here in this pocket, you know what most people will say, Priscilla?
No.
They'll say, that wasn't magic. That was just sleight of hand. It's obvious you either pretended to put it in your hand, really kept it the other, went up this sleeve, came out that sleeve, some kind of mess like that, right? But Priscilla, if you held my wrist, and I showed you the knife, Priscilla, and I closed my hand, and when I opened it again, that knife was gone, and you never took your eyes off my hand, and you never let go, and I opened my hand, that knife was gone, that would not be sleight of hand, would it?
No.
That would be real magic, wouldn't it?
You're really not insured, are you? Yeah,
I'm not. That would be real magic, is it not?
Yes.
Okay. Folks, if you see the knife right here, I close my hand and open it again, that knife is gone. Under these conditions, that would be real magic, would it not?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yep.
No one can do that. Well, think about it. The only way that could happen is if the magician first creates what we call the intricate web of distraction. You want to see that baby in operation, Wendy?
Yes. Yeah.
Don't pay attention. This is just to distract you. No, it's two knives.
What?
But how else? See, you have two knives. I have a little black knife, and I have a little white knife. This one is held what we call the palming position. From this side, you can see it. From this side, you cannot. See, it's a principle of magic. As long as you hold your hand in a perfectly natural fashion, no one's ever going to suspect it has a little white knife hidden on the other side. So when this hand comes near the black knife, we switch, and then we switch back. It's the secret to the whole thing. Now that you know how it's done, I'll do it slow motion. We'll put the white knife over here in this hand, black knife in this hand. Which knife is in this hand? No, that's the switch. That's what we're trying to demonstrate. I'll do it again. White knife. Mm-hmm. White knife in this hand. Mm-hmm. Black knife in this hand. Which knife is in this hand?
Black.
No, honey, that's the switch. Look, I bet it's confusing you guys having two knives out. We'll get rid of just one. Just using the little black knife, you hold my wrist really tight.
Oh, Lord.
White knife over here, you hold this wrist really tight. Which knife is in this hand?
White one.
Which knife is in this hand?
Black one.
Guess again.
Oh,
white
one.
Oh, good guess. But remember what I said about the intricate web of distraction?
Uh-huh.
Oh. Oh.
Wait. Guess which knife is in my pocket?
The white one.
Nope, black one. Black one.
Wow.
I get confused myself sometimes.